Hello friends, welcome to my channel Biotech Tutorials. Today I will discuss about biofortification. So first of all, the question arises, why there is a need of biofortification? There are some issues, or we can say there are some problems due to which there is a need of biofortification. That is hidden hunger. And now, what is hidden hunger? It is the condition of malnutrition where the body lacks essential vitamins and minerals that keep people healthy. Micronutrient deficiencies such as zinc, iron and vitamin A can cause harm to the body, that is growth stunting, blindness, mental retardation. Nearly 2 billion people are affected globally. Now, further, what is the purpose of biofortification? So, to reduce the mortality rate and morbidity rate related to micronutrient deficiency. Now, what is mortality rate? It is the measure of number of deaths. And morbidity rate is rate at which a disease occurs in a population. What is the next purpose? To increase food security, productivity and quality of living in developing countries. Now, what is biofortification? It is the process of increasing the micronutrient content of a food. So, breeding is done to increase their nutritional value. It is a feasible and cost-effective means of delivering micronutrients to populations. Now, confusion arises that what is biofortification and what is fortification. There is a difference between biofortification and fortification. First of all, biofortification focuses on making plant food more nutritious as the plants are growing. On the other hand, in fortification, nutrients are added to the food when they are processed. This is the major difference between biofortification and fortification. Now, what methodology used for biofortification? There are three methods due to which we can increase the nutritional value of crops. First is selective breeding, second is genetic modification, and third is seed priming. First of all, what is selective breeding? Crossbreeding between high nutrient varieties with high yielding varieties. Study must be conducted to observe whether the consumer can absorb the extra nutrients and also the extent to which storage, processing and cooking of the crops affect their available nutrient levels. Second is genetic modification. The main example of this is golden rice, developed for its nutritional value. It contains increased level of beta carotene, which can be converted to vitamin A by the body. Now, last is seed priming. Prime seeds by bombarding them with iron oxide nanoparticles before sowing. This would accumulate more iron and thus increase the nutritive value of the grains. That's all in biofortification. If you like this video, then please share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.